And now I am doing something I have never done before on a Stephen Holt show. Yes, it's a first. The first time in 22 years I'm breaking with old tradition and interviewing a director of photography, a DP. It's the brilliant Christian Berger from White Ribbon, which I named the best film of the year. Hey, Christian. How do you do? Guten Tag.
Good. Fine.
So I loved your movie, The White Ribbon. Exquisite black and white. How did you do that? It was shot in HD or something? Or how did you get that incredible look?
I stayed with a good old film and did the marriage with the digital technology after shooting.
Oh.
Which is a standard today, really. No, but it was a bit more complicated because for Michael Haneke, for me too, it was
Michael Haneke, the director. Yeah.
Haneke, the director. It was always clear it has to be a black and white film.
But where did you shoot this in Germany?
In northern Germany, in the ex-east part, to find that landscapes.
Unspoiled, yeah.
Yes. And even the village as well. It was 1.5 hours north from Berlin. And the big barn, you said?
Mm-hmm, the barn, yeah.
It was near to the Baltic Sea.
Wow. So how many years have you been working with Michael? Michael Haneke, the director.
Yeah.
Is this your first project with him, or?
I did my first film in 91 or two with him.
Oh, wow. So you've been working with him for
so
a long 20 years.
Fifth, I think it's the fifth feature, yeah.
So when does the director of photography, who, I mean, if I was ever to make a film someday, if I was lucky enough, the first thing I would do was to get a fantastic DP. And how, so you were, you always work with him now? I mean, like all the films we
no,
know?
No, he did a few, he did Funny Games US in the States.
That's right, yes, which was on my top 10 list last year.
Yeah. Then he did one pure French production, Code Inconnu in...
Is that Cachet? No.
No. That was
you did
mixed,
Cachet.
Yes.
Wonderful.
So it depends very
that.
Often from the production conditions if a country has to bring in a DOP or an actor or a producer or whatever.
Well, what was the most difficult part of the of making The White Ribbon, do you think, for you?
To hold 16 week the concentration on that
16 weeks. That's some people think that's a long time to shoot a film.
For Europe, it's for the normal conditions, it's quite long. But Michael Haneke, he takes his time. He uses it very, very efficace. But he takes his time, and we had a lot of work with kids. You
yes,
plan.
We're all wonderful
you
child
cannot,
actors.
You cannot say faster now; it doesn't work. But that it's a long time, and you have, for me a film, especially with Michael, is like an expedition. I'm not in a country, I'm not in a town, I'm just in the movie. Like now I'm here in New York, but I don't know it really. It stays on the ticket, New York. But I'm just here and have a lot of talks and interviews.
Well, where are you from in Germany? Which part?
Vienna.
Vienna. Oh, you're from Austria. Okay,
yeah,
Michael.
Yeah.
Is Michael Austrian too?
Austrian too, yeah.
Yeah, I was told that I have part of my background is also German and Austrian too. And I had one play that I wrote called The Role of Kevin Christian, translated and published in Germany by Fischer Verlag.
Yeah.
And it was called Die Rolle de Kevin Christian. And they said they couldn't find anybody who could capture my sense of humor. They had to go to an Austrian.
This is very true.
So, I don't know what I got that's Austrian, but I guess there's a certain kind of...
It's different. We have the same language, but very different music. Different. We are more the Slavic or Latino.
Mm-hmm.
No, not Latino, but the Italian part.
Aha,
in the
okay.
West, it's more influenced from Roman past, and in the East, more Slavic past. And in Germany, it's a border. We say always it's a border between beer and wine.
Okay, okay.